this week's Know Your Rights segment, Catherine Stone from Barbas Law is discussing an important aspect of workers' compensation, the importance of reporting your work accident and the issues surrounding it. Good morning. Good to see you.
How are you?
So this is interesting. My first thought, are people not reporting it at all or maybe just not correctly?
Well, and like you said before we got started, reporting it to who?
Yeah.
So we've talked previously before about the timelines with regards to reporting a work-related accident. But it's also important to know who to report it to, and then what that person should be doing.
Just like with an auto accident. I mean, it's very similar,
yes.
Yeah.
So there's rules that surround this. So number one is you need to make your employer aware.
Okay.
Now,
is there a timeline there?
Yes, it's typically 30 days from the date of the accident.
Okay.
Some employers may, by manual or HR guidelines, require that you report it immediately. Again, you should follow your employer's guidelines, but at a maximum, it's 30 days. Now, there are other instances where it can be extended, and I won't go into those.
Okay.
But for the most part, it's 30 days from the date of the accident.
And when you say report it to your employer, can you just walk by, hey, I fell, or hey,
No, you should legally... Again, we've talked about the importance of forms.
Okay,
there is an actual form that the state of Florida Division of Workers' Compensation has approved called a first report of injury.
Okay. And so every employer should have these.
Every employer should have that form. Every employer should have you fill out that form, or you should stand there while they fill out that form. That is the form they should be submitting.
They fill it out or you fill it out, the person who's injured?
Some employers will fill them out themselves. Some employers have their own report of injury.
Okay.
They will fill it out. They'll get your information. Either you're filling it out. It's very important that you get a copy of whatever is filled out.
Okay.
Because in turn, they then should take that report of injury and submit it to their workers' comp insurance company.
Okay.
And that opens your claim. That's what starts you getting medical treatment. That's potentially what starts you getting paid under workers' compensation if you are eligible. If you fail to report it timely, then they have a defense, and it's called the notice defense. You fail to give timely notice.
So then do cases get shut down right then and there?
Yes, they're basically not compensable at that point. So I had a client recently who...
I was just going to ask how often.
Yeah, you know, I always have one of those, and he had a back claim, and he did not, he suspected it was due from heavy lifting at work.
Mm-hmm.
Per se, he'd been to the doctor, but hadn't really gotten a doctor to say that that's what it was, mm-hmm. was due from. But he didn't put his employer on notice. He didn't say, hey, I'm going to the doctor. I think this might be due to work, which kind of leads me into my next part is, if you think it's due to work, you should always report it to your employer. Now, the flip side is, I get clients that say this all the time, well, if I report it to my employer,
I was just going to bring this up.
They may fire me. Well, technically, they should not be able to fire you for reporting a workers' comp injury or pursuing a workers' comp case, because that is a violation of Florida statute 44205. It's the work comp retaliation statute. Now, employers can dream up many different ways of getting around that, but usually we look at the timing.
Okay.
So, I mean, if you report the accident and you're let go the next day, then that's pretty significant.
Now, before we get ready to wrap up here, because obviously there is an accident where something is very noticeable, you know, like, okay, that's where you can pinpoint it. But in a case where it may be an overtime thing that all of a sudden you're having issues.
Those are called repetitive trauma claims.
So is that when you would let your, before you go talk to a doctor, that's when you would actually
put
in the notice?
Well, with repetitive trauma claims, that can be 30 days from the last exposure to that job.
Okay.
So in other words, if you have a heavy lifting job and you know you suspect it might be due from heavy lifting, the last time you did that job and that mm-hmm. particular job, then that starts your clock for the 30 days.
Okay.
So in my client's instance, he had taken FMLA And he had not, we had blown past his reporting, his notice requirement.
Well, again, we're just scratching the surface on maybe some of the many questions that I'd imagine, but that's when you and your team say, we encourage that. Give us a call.
Always give us a call.
Yeah. We love when you're here. Thank you so much. We learned so much. Look forward to seeing you again soon.